गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, आता जो आपला लेक्चर आहे तो आपण एलिमेंट्सचे पोझिशन, काही मॉलिक्युलर स्ट्रक्चर, क्रिस्टलाइन स्ट्रक्चर्स ह्यांचे आपण डिटेल पार्ट स्टडी करणार आहोत. त्यामध्ये काही स्ट्रक्चर्स जे आहे बऱ्याचदा मी तुम्हाला लेक्चरच्या वेळेस एक्सप्लेन केलेलं आहे, बरोबर आहे. ना काय काय स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी करणार आहे, पहिले थोडेसे बेसिक स्ट्रक्चरचे पॉइंट्स बघूया. एलिमेंट्सना कसे डिवाइड करायचे, सो कोण स्फिअर असतात, कोण ऑक्टेडल व्हॉइड्स असतात, कोण टेट्राडल व्हॉइड्स असतात, आणि त्यांना कसे डिवाइड करायचे किंवा इझिली आयडेंटिफाय करता यायला पाहिजे, असे आपल्याला काही हिंट्स बघायचे आहेत. बेसिक कन्सेप्ट आहेत, खूप बेसिक आहेत, काही अडचण नाही आहे, काय अवघड नाही आहे. ओके, सो एक्झाम्पल्स ऑफ क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर्स, त्यापैकी स्ट्रक्चर जे आहे हे ए बी टाईपचे किंवा ए टू बी टाईपचे किंवा ए बी टू टाईपचे, ह्या टाईपचे एक्झाम्पल्स असतात. तर त्यापैकी फर्स्ट पार्ट आपण जो स्टडी करणार आहे तो आहे ए बी टाईप सॉलिड. मग ए बी टाईप सॉलिड म्हणजे काय असणार आहे, ह्यामध्ये ए हा एक कॅटायन आहे, बी एक एनायन आहे, है ना. सो एक कॅटायन एक एनायन असलेले सॉल्ट्स, आयनिक कंपाऊंड, सो त्याला म्हणतात ए बी टाईप सॉल्ट्स. माझ्यामध्ये काय काय एक्झाम्पल्स येऊ शकतो, सीझियम क्लोराईड येऊ शकतो, एक सीझियम एक क्लोराईड ना, एन ए सेल येऊ शकतो, झेड एन एस येऊ शकतो. ओके, एक पॉईंट लक्षात ठेवा, जे काही फॉर्म्युला देणार आहेत आपण इथे ए बी ए बी टू ए टू बी, त्यापैकी पहिला पार्ट जो असतो ऑलवेज कॅटायन असतो, म्हणजे इथे ए हा कॅटायन आहे आणि बी हा एनायन आहे. सो म्हणजे ऑलवेज इनिशियल पार्ट कॅटायन असतो, सेकंड पार्ट एनायन असतो. मग तुम्ही कुठलाही आयनिक फॉर्म लिहिला तो आयपीसी सिस्टीम आहे, त्याला चेंज करता येत नाही. सो राईट द आयनिक कंपाऊंड फर्स्ट, यू हॅव टू राईट अ कॅटायन, अँड देन इन द सेकंड पार्ट यू हॅव टू राईट एनायन. सो दॅट इज द सिक्वेन्स, सिंपल सिक्वेन्स. नाउ द पॉइंट काय आहे, ए बी टाईप सॉलिड मध्ये हे चार एक्झाम्पल्स आपण डिटेल स्टडी करणार आहे. त्यापैकी एन ए सी एल आहे, झेड एन एस आहे, सीझियम क्लोराईड आहे आणि डायमंड आहे. नॉर्मली आपण जेवढे स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी करणार आहोत त्या सगळ्या स्ट्रक्चर्स मध्ये एन ए सी एल, झेड एन एस, डायमंड किंवा बरेचसे सगळे स्ट्रक्चर्स हे एफ सी सी स्ट्रक्चर्स आहेत, त्यामुळे तुम्हाला लक्षात ठेवायला काय अवघड होणार नाही, इझी आहे. हा, सीझियम क्लोराईड एक लक्षात ठेवावं लागेल, सीझियम क्लोराईड बी सी सी स्ट्रक्चर असतो, तो एक कंपल्सरी लक्षात ठेवावं लागेल. कोरंडम म्हणून एक स्ट्रक्चर आहे, तो एच सी पी असतो. म्हणजे हे दोन एक्झाम्पल्स बेसिकली लक्षात ठेवला, बाकी सगळे नॉर्मली तरी एफ सी सी चे आहेत, आयनिक सॉलिड्स. ओके, सो ए बी टाईप मध्ये हे चार पार्ट असणार आहेत. तसे ए बी टू टाईप सॉलिड, ह्याला म्हणतात फ्लोराईड स्ट्रक्चर. हा, ए बी टू स्ट्रक्चर मध्ये ए हा कॅटायन आहे, बी हा एनायन आहे. ह्या पार्ट मध्ये, ह्या स्ट्रक्चर मध्ये, फ्लोराईड स्ट्रक्चर मध्ये कंप्लीट सिलॅबस मध्ये, नॉर्मली आपण आतापर्यंत जे काही स्टडी केला, एनायन्स शुड बी स्पियर्स, कॅटायन्स शुड बी व्हॉइड्स. फक्त हा एकच स्ट्रक्चर असा आहे, कोणी ए बी टू, हा एकच असा स्ट्रक्चर आहे ज्याच्यामध्ये ए हा कॅटायन आहे पण स्पियर असणार आहे, बी हा एनायन आहे, हा व्हॉइड असणार आहे. आता कुठला व्हॉइड कसे डिसाइड करायचे आपण बघूया आपण पुढे ते. सो त्यामुळे तुम्हाला एक सांगितलेलं आहे की मोस्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर्स एनायन्स स्पियर्स असतात, कॅटायन्स व्हॉइड्स असतात, पण फ्लोराईड स्ट्रक्चर याचे काही एक्झाम्पल्स आहेत, ते एक्झाम्पल्स आपण घेऊया. बेसिक एक्झाम्पल सी ए एफ टू असणार आहे, तो सोडून बरेचसे एक्झाम्पल्स आहेत. तर ए बी टू मध्ये एक ए पॉझिटिव्ह आहे, बी निगेटिव्ह आहे, ए प्लस टू चा असतो. तर ए हा स्पियर आहे, कॅटायन, हा एक स्ट्रक्चर आहे. ए हा कॅटायन असून स्पियर आहे, बी हा एनायन असून व्हॉइड आहे, त्यामुळे याला फ्लोराईड स्ट्रक्चर म्हणतात. त्याचं एक्झाम्पल सी ए एफ टू, अगेन एफ सी सी आहे, सोपा लक्षात ठेवायला काय अडचण नाही आहे. दुसरा जो आहे ए टू बी, आता पॉईंट काय, वरती ए बी टू होता आणि हा ए टू बी होता, डिफरन्स काय आहे, वरती एक ए आहे, दोन बी आहे, सी मध्ये दोन ए आणि एक बी आहे, सो चार जनी नंबर ऑफ कैटायन्स एन एस डिफरन्स आलेले आहेत. सर म्हणतात अँटी फ्लोराईड, ऍक्च्युली नाव अँटी फ्लोराईड आहे पण हा आतापर्यंत जेवढे स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी केले त्याला फॉलो करतो. हा नाव आहे फ्लोराईड पण उलटा स्ट्रक्चर आहे. उलटा म्हणजे कसा, कॅटायन्स स्पियर्स आहेत फ्लोराईड मध्ये, अँटी फ्लोराईड अँटी म्हणजे उलटा है ना. सो अँटी फ्लोराईड मध्ये कॅटायन्स व्हॉइड्स आहेत, एनायन स्पियर आहेत. म्हणजे आपल्याला नावावरनं लक्ष ठेवायची नाही, कारण का अँटी म्हणजे उलटं असं लक्ष ठेवतात आणि कॅटायन्सना स्पियर करून टाकतात अँटी फ्लोराईड मध्ये, पण तो चुकीचा पार्ट आहे. अँटी फ्लोराईड हा सरळ स्ट्रक्चर फॉलो करतो, आतापर्यंत जेवढी स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी केलाय त्या टाईपचा, आणि फ्लोराईड उलटा स्ट्रक्चर फॉलो करतो. सो दॅट्स वाय फ्लोराईड म्हणजे उलटा स्ट्रक्चर, ऍक्च्युली स्ट्रक्चरचे अरेंजमेंट बेस्ड सांगतोय मी. आणि अँटी फ्लोराईड म्हणजे सरळ स्ट्रक्चर, सरळ कॅटायन्स एनएस स्पियर्स एनएस आणि व्हॉइड्स फॉलो करणार आहे. ह्यामध्ये एक्झाम्पल जो आहे एन ए टू ओ, के टू ओ, ह्या टाईपचे एक्झाम्पल्स असणार आहेत, है ना. सो एक एक एक्झाम्पल बघू, कारण सगळे सेम पॅटर्न्स आहेत. सी ए एफ टू चे फ्लोराईडचे जे आहेत त्यामध्ये सी ए एफ टू, बी ए एफ टू, बी ए सी एल टू, ह्या टाईपचे कंपाऊंड्स आहेत. सगळ्यांचं स्ट्रक्चर सेमच आहे, त्यामुळे आपण काय करणार आहे, एक स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी करूया सी एफ टू चा. इथे देखील ए टू बी मध्ये के टू ओ, एन ए टू ओ, ह्या टाईपचे बरेचसे स्ट्रक्चर्स आहेत. आपण इथे एकच स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी करणार आहोत, सगळे पॅटर्न सेमच आहेत, त्यामुळे एक सिंपल पॅटर्न त्यापैकी के टू ओचा स्टडी करणार आहोत. देन पुढे आहे डी, पेरोड स्केच स्ट्रक्चर. हा एक इंडिव्हिज्युअल स्ट्रक्चर आहे, तीन टाइम ऍटम्स असतात त्यामध्ये, बघा आपण ते. स्पायनल अँड अँटी स्पायनल स्ट्रक्चर हा देखील पेरोड स्केच स्ट्रक्चर टाईपचा आहे, पण इथे एक ए, दोन बी आणि चार ओ असणार आहेत. त्यामुळे पॉईंट काय आहे, ए बी टू ओ फोर हा जो स्ट्रक्चर आहे त्याला म्हणतात स्पायनल. ह्यामध्येच अँटी स्पायनल असे दोन स्ट्रक्चर्स आहेत. स्पायनल अँटी स्पायनल मध्ये छोटासा फरक आहे, तो छोटासा फरक आपण त्या पार्ट मध्ये डिटेल मध्ये स्टडी करू. कोरंडम स्ट्रक्चर, कोरंडम स्ट्रक्चर तुम्ही ते ऑक्साईड साठी अप्लिकेबल आहे, ट्रे ऑक्साईड म्हणतात त्याला. मग इथे तुम्ही काय काय एक्झाम्पल्स घेऊ शकता, ए एल टू ओ थ्री किंवा त्या टाईपचे कुठले जे काय असतील, बोरॉन बी टू ओ थ्री, हे जे आहेत ह्या टाईपचे एक्झाम्पल्स तुम्ही कोरंडम मध्ये स्टडी करणार आहात. आणि शेवटचा जो आहे रुटाईल स्ट्रक्चर, ह्यामध्ये पेरोडस्केट आणि रुटाईल आपण नॉर्मली जस्ट हेडिंग करणार आहे, ते सोडून बाकी सगळे स्ट्रक्चरचे डिटेल कव्हर करूया, कारण का हे डिटेल बाकीच्या स्ट्रक्चरचे आलेले आहेत क्वेश्चन आणि क्वेश्चन अवेलेबल आहेत, त्यामुळे सगळे स्ट्रक्चर्स वन बाय वन कव्हर करू. ओके, सो पहिला पार्ट कव्हर करताना आपण काय करूयात की कोण ऑक्टेटल वर्ड पाहिजे, कोण टेट्राहेड्रल वर्ड पाहिजे, कसे डिसाइड करायचे ते बघूया, आणि देन एक एक स्ट्रक्चर स्टडी करूया. ए बी टाईप क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर, ए बी टाईप क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर मध्ये एनएसीएल, सीजीएम क्लोराईड, जड एनएस वगैरे होते, डायमंड पण आहे, पण आता इथे डायमंड याच्यासाठी कळा नाही, कारण डायमंड मध्ये फक्त कार्बन आहे, त्याला ए बी म्हणता येणार नाही, पण तो ए बी टाईपचा स्ट्रक्चर फॉलो करतो. पुढे डायग्राम आपण डिटेल बघूया. सो सध्या आपण इथे तीन पार्ट डिवाइड करणार आहे, वन ऑफ देम इज द एनएसीएल, अँड सेकंड वन इज द सीजीएम क्लोराईड, अँड थर्ड वन इज द जड एन एस. सो फर्स्ट स्ट्रक्चर, फर्स्ट वन इज द एनएसीएल. एनएसीएल फॉलोज एफ सी सी स्ट्रक्चर. In this NaCl FCC structure, chloride ions occupies all spheres. आपल्याला माहिती आहे स्पियर्स कुठे असतात आता, है ना, तरी पुढे मी डिटेल मध्ये घेणारच आहे त्यांना. सो द पोझिशन ऑफ स्पियर्स इज द 8 कॉर्नर्स अँड 6 फेसेस ऑफ अ क्यूब. देन Na प्लस आयन, Na प्लस इज अ बल्कियर कटायन, है ना. Na प्लस बिलोंग्स टू S ब्लॉक, सोडियम ऐटम बिलोंग्स टू S ब्लॉक. S block metal atoms are the bulkier atoms, hence Na plus occupies octahedral void. Why? Because Na plus is a bulkier cation. So that's it. If you are having a bulkier cation, and one more thing, always a unit cell contains, if a unit cell contains n number of spheres, then it should contain n number of octahedral voids and 2n number of tetrahedral voids. So here in this structure we are having, if we are having n number of Cl minus ions, then there should be n number of Na plus ions, because we are having 1:1 ratio of NaCl. So that's why Na should be the octahedral void only, right? So we are having two possibilities, number of spheres if number of spheres is equal to number of voids, then that void mostly it should be octahedral void. If that void is a smaller in size at the time, the void occupies tetrahedral position, but not complete tetrahedral, half of the tetrahedral, because initial contains 2n number of tetrahedral voids, that is it twice number of tetrahedral voids than spheres. So that's why NaCl, in NaCl we are having same number of Na and Cl, so that's why Na it should occupy octahedral void based on size and a number. Then second structure, coordination number. In NaCl, Na plus occupies octahedral void, so the coordination number of octahedral void is the 6. Automatically coordination number of both the ions, it becomes 6:6. So coordination number of Na is 6. First number, first digit indicates coordination number of cation, second digit indicates coordination number of anion. So coordination number of Na and Cl is the 6:6. Then second one is the ZNS. So in this ZNS, again ZNS follows FCC structure. Now sulfide, S is the sulfide, zinc Zn plus cation plus 2 cation. So in zinc sulfide, zinc blend, both are same. Sulfide occupies sphere. In FCC we are having 6 corner at 8 corner atoms and 6 faces atoms for the sphere. That is a fixed part, compulsory part. Now the position of Zn plus 2 ion. Zn plus 2 ion, first thing, number of Zn plus 2 ions is equivalent to number of sulfide ions. So that means we are having two possibilities. Zinc should occupy octahedral void because of same number of spheres and octahedral voids, or zinc should occupy half of the tetrahedral void. You know, ka the spheres picture double tetrahedral voids asta. So that's why doganche number same asliamule double chevji apan half vapanar, half recombinant karnar. So that means we are having two possibilities. Now the out of two possibility, based on size, you have to select the position of Zn plus 2 ion. Here, zinc belongs to D block element, which is on extreme right side. So hence, zinc is a smaller cation. Hence, it should occupy tetrahedral void. So, position of tetrahedral void, Zn plus 2 ion, is the half of the tetrahedral void. You know, number of spheres should be equal to number of voids. Why? We are having same number of zinc and sulfur. Hence, half of the tetrahedral voids are occupied by the Zn plus 2 ions. So this is the ZNS structure. Then, coordination number. What is the coordination number of zinc tetrahedral void? 4. So that's why both the ions shows coordination number 4:4. Actually, coordination number of sulfide should be 8. But half of the tetrahedral voids you are using, then that means half of the tetrahedral voids are remains vacant. Hence, coordination number 8 changes to 4. So that's why ZNS shows coordination number 4:4. Then the next one is the diamond. Diamond follows FCC structure and which is equivalent to ZNS. So instead of writing Zn and S elements, we have to write carbon atoms. So in diamond, sphere is a carbon and half of the tetrahedral void is also a carbon. This is the structure of diamond, right? Then AB2 structure. AB2 structure, that is a fluoride structure. AB2 structure is also known as fluoride structure. In AB2, A having plus 2 charge, B having minus 1 charge, right? And as compared to B, as compared to number of B ions, A plus 2 ions are in half number. So now the structure of Ab2, fluoride structure. Example is the CaF2, right? In the CaF2, Ca plus 2 is the cation, F minus is a anion. But fluoride is a smaller anion. Hence, fluoride ion goes to a void position. And calcium belongs to S block. And that too belongs to alkaline earth metal. And a fourth period. So, calcium is a bulkier cation. Hence, only in this structure, fluoride structure, cation occupies sphere, anion occupies void. Difference samajhna? Calcium bulky hai, alkaline earth metal element hai, fourth period element hai, humein khub bulky hai. So it occupies void position, sphere position. And fluorine, extreme right side, upper element, hence it should be smaller in size. So it will occupy void position. Ata difference kya hai? हा खूप सोपा स्ट्रक्चर आहे बघा. जेवढे स्पियर्स आहेत म्हणजे कॅल्शियम, त्यापेक्षा डबल व्हॉइड्स आहेत. मग आपल्याकडे एकच ऑप्शन आहे, स्पियर पेक्षा डबल व्हॉइड्स असलेला कोण आहे? तर दॅट शुड बी दी टेट्राहेड्रल व्हॉइड ओनली. सो स्ट्रक्चर, कॅल्शियम प्लस 2 ऑक्युपाइज अ स्पियर पोझिशन, फ्लोराईड ऑक्युपाइज अ टेट्राहेड्रल व्हॉइड पोझिशन बिकॉज ऑफ ट्वाइस नंबर है ना. इथे दिलेले बघा, टेट्राहेड्रल व्हॉइड, कॅल्शियम ऑक्युपाइज स्पियर पोझिशन, फ्लोराईड ऑक्युपाइज टेट्राहेड्रल व्हॉइड. सो दिस इज द फ्लोराईड स्ट्रक्चर. नाउ इन दिस पॉइंट, इफ यू आर हैविंग 4 नंबर ऑफ कॅल्शियम एटम्स एट अ टाइम, देयर शुड बी 8 फ्लोराईड आयन्स. सो नंबर इट शुड बी डिफरंट, हेन्स कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर शुड बी डिफरंट. नाउ इफ यू आर हैविंग अ बल्कियर आयन, दैट बल्कियर आयन normally having a huge surface area. So more is the surface area, more will be the coordination number. And if the atom is smaller, ion is smaller in size at the time, the surface area will be small. Hence, coordination number should be less. Hence, calcium having more coordination number, fluorine having less coordination number. So the coordination number of calcium is 8. One sphere is connected to 8 tetrahedral voids. While one tetrahedral void is connected to 4 spheres. So that's why coordination number should be 8:4. So this is the fluoride structure. Other examples of fluoride structures are SRF2, BAF2, PBF2, and BACL2. Then A2B structure. A2B structure is also known as antifluoride. Actually, antifluoride follows normal pattern. Fluoride structure follows inverse pattern. So, in the fluoride structure, cation occupies sphere position, anion occupies void position. While in all other examples, anion follows sphere position and cation follows void position. So, A2B is the antifluoride structure. In this one, example is the Na2O. Again, fluoride, antifluoride, both follows FCC structure. In this antifluoride structure, sodium belongs to alkali metals and oxygen anion is a bulkier ion. Hence, anion occupies sphere position. That means it should be at 8 corners and 6 faces. Again, problem is the, as compared to number of spheres, we are having double number of voids. So double number of voids, it should occupy tetrahedral position only. Again, so Na plus ions are twice that of spheres, so Na plus ions occupies tetrahedral void. Simple condition. Again, Na plus ion is a smaller ion, O minus is a bulkier ion, Na plus is a tetrahedral void, so tetrahedral void shows coordination number 4. Oxygen is a sphere. Remember always one thing, one of the tetrahedral void should be connected to 4 spheres, but one sphere, it should be connected to 8 tetrahedral void. Why?
proctoidal
voids.
Each octoidal void should be connected to 6 spheres, and each sphere should be connected to 6 octoidal voids, and that is the condition for octoidal void only. So in the NaCl, coordination number is the 6:6. Here the coordination number should be 4:8. Na is a smaller ion, cation, so it shows less coordination number. Oxygen is a bulkier cation, anion, it shows higher coordination number. Other examples of antichloride structures: Li2O, K2O, Rb2O, Rb2S. Okay, so these are the antichloride structures. Then first structure, we'll see the complete detailed structures of NaCl: cesium chloride, ZnS, diamond, Ab2, A2B, and then we'll go for spinal antispinal structure. Okay, so in the NaCl structure, normally NaCl follows FCC structure, right? Then this one is the NaCl structure. This is the a single unit cell, not 8 unit cells. This one is the single unit cell. So in these unit cells, green ions are the chloride ions, which are bulkier in size, nah? So green one is the chloride ion, and blue one is the Na plus ion, right? Okay, so in NaCl structure, Cl minus is the anion. Anions normally are the spheres, and we know the position of spheres, which are at the corners and the faces. Position of sphere, Cl minus ion. Cl minus is ion, is at 8 corners and 6 faces. Why? 8 corners plus 6 faces, that means total 14 Cl minus ions required. Occupied Cl minus ions. 8 corners, we are having 8 corners, each corner occupies 1/8 the part. Hence, 1/8 the part into 8, it gives 1 Cl minus ion. So from the corner terms, we'll get 1 Cl minus ion. And we are having 6 faces, each face occupies a Cl minus ion, and each face occupies half of the atom. Hence, the coordination, the total number of Cl minus ion occupied in the unit cells, it should be equal to 3 Cl minus ions. So total number of Cl minus ions, 1 from corner and 3 from faces. So total number of anions occupied should be equal to 4 Cl minus ions. Then, so this one is for Cl minus ions, anions, spheres. Now, we'll see the cations. Cations, Na plus ion. Na plus ions normally occupies the octoidal void because the same ratio of Na and Cl and size of Na. So position of void, it can be decided on two points. In that, first point is the number of voids with respect to spheres, and second is the size of void. Okay, here cation Na plus ion is a bulkier, so it occupies octoidal void. So the position of octoidal voids is the 12 edges and one body center. In this one, green atoms are the Na plus ion, and blue atoms are the Cl minus ions. Blue balls are the Cl minus ions, green balls are the Na plus ions. So we are having the position of octoidal voids. Now we'll see the occupied number of atoms. Before that, total Na plus ions are required, it should be close to 13, 12 from the edges, 1 from the body center. So to form one NaCl in its cell, it requires 14 Cl minus ions and 13 Na plus ions. So one of the NaCl unit cell is formed by 13 Na plus ions and 14 Cl minus ions. If the number is different, but actually as a whole unit cell or any crystal structure, it should be neutral in state. So neutral or neutrality point is based on occupied number of ions, not formed ions. occupied number of ions will decide the neutrality of a crystal structure. Okay, we'll see the z value of say Na plus ion, then you will get the point here. We are having 12 edges, each edge occupy 1/4 the part of Na plus ion. So that's why 12 edges into 1/4, it gives 3 Na plus ions from the edges and 1 from the body center. That means total again we are having 4 Na plus ions. So that means a unit cell of NaCl contain 4 Na plus ions and 4 Cl minus ions occupied part as a whole part. So hence NaCl unit cell is a neutral in state. So neutrality that depends on Z value of cation and anion, not depends on total ion. Okay, so this one is the NaCl structure, simplest structure. So same statement, one NaCl unit cell is formed by 14 Cl minus ion and 13 Na plus ions, while the one unit cell occupies 4 Na plus ions and 4 Cl minus ions. So this is the NaCl structure. Now in the next part we'll see structure of cesium chloride. So in the structure of cesium chloride, so this is the structure of cesium chloride, BCC structure. Cesium chloride follows BCC structure. So at the center we are having cesium atom and the corners are should be Cl minus ions. So this one is the Cl minus ion, which is a sphere, and at the center we are having cesium plus ion, which is a void, and this void is the cubic void, the void which is present at the body center and formed in the BCC structure. It should be cubic void only, which is having a radius ratio of 0.732:1. Okay, let's see the positions Z value of cesium and chlorine. So in cesium chloride follows BCC structure. In cesium chloride, chlorine shows a position of spheres, and spheres are present at 8 corners plus 6 faces. This one is a BCC structure, na? So spheres are at the corners only, not at the body faces. That's why here we have to count only 8 corners, not 6 faces. So occupied atoms, it should be equals to 1. That means a unit cell of cesium chloride occupies only 1 Cl minus ion, but which is formed by 8 Cl minus ions. Formed by 8 Cl minus ions, occupied only 1 Cl minus ion. Right. Cubic void. Cesium plus ion is a cubic void. Cesium plus ion is a cubic void, which is at the, which is present at the body center. So body center, that means it should be a whole body center atom is occupied. So that's why occupied cation is equals to 1. Hence one of the cesium chloride unit cell is formed by 8 Cl minus ions and 1 cesium plus ion, and occupied part which should be equals to 1 cesium plus atom and ion and 1 Cl minus ion. Hence, as a whole, cesium chloride unit cell is a neutral in state, or cesium chloride crystal structure should be neutral in state. Right? So, neutrality again depends on Z value, not total number of atoms. So, this is the cesium chloride structure. Now, let's see the next structure. Next one is the ZNS. So, this one is the ZNS structure. Here we are having two types of spheres, balls. In it, first ball is the yellow ball, which is a sulfide ion. And second is the blue ball, which is a zinc ion. So we are having zinc ion and sulfur ion. In this structure, number of voids, that means zinc and spheres, are in same ratio. So again, we are having two possibilities. Zinc may occupies all the octadal voids or half of the tetradal void. Tetradal void should be twice than spheres, now. So that's why zinc occupies all the octadal voids or half of the tetradal voids. Now let's see. That depends on size. In the next part, ZNS structure follows FCC structure. In this one, sulfide S2 minus is a sphere which occupies 8 corners per 6 faces. Position, that is the position. And occupied number of anions, it should be equals to 8 corner atoms. Each corner occupies 1/8, and 6 faces atoms, each face occupies half part. So that means total occupied sulfur ions should be equals to 4. So this one is the sulfur ions, number of sulfur ions. Then a zinc sulfide in your cell is formed by 14 sulfur ions. Formed by 14 sulfur ions, but occupied is the 4 sulfur ions. Then next one is zinc plus 2 ions. Zn plus 2 ions, zinc belongs to D block element, and which is on extreme right side, D10 element. So zinc should be smaller in size, hence it should occupy tetradal void. But the ratio of spheres and voids, it should be same. Hence, we have to occupy half of the tetradal void only. Hence, Zn plus 2 shows tetradal void position. Out of total number of tetradal voids, half of the tetradal we have to use. And that should be alternated tetradal void. So, position of Zn plus 2 is the alternate border diagonal. That means each border diagonal contains only zinc plus 1 zinc plus ion, zinc plus 2 ion, and second one, it remains vacant. Occupied. Each border diagonal occupies only 1 Zn plus 2 ion. We are having 4 border diagonals in a cube. That means total number of occupied ions should be equals to 4. So, one of the ZnS structure is formed by 14 sulfur ions and 4 Zn plus 2 ion. But this one will not give the explanation of charge. Right. But one of the ZnS structure, zinc blend structure, occupies 4 Zn plus 2 ions and 4 sulfide ions. So, hence, ZnS crystal structure, it should be neutral in state. So, this one is the ZnS structure. Let's see the next structure. Structure of diamond. Structure of diamond, it should be equivalent to ZnS structure. Why? Because all this position of zinc and sulfur is occupied by carbon only. That means, in the diamond structure, carbon is at corners plus faces plus alternate border diagonal. Simple point. So this is the structure of diamond, carbon. Here green parts, green balls are the carbon atoms and blue balls are also the carbon atoms. Carbon atom, green one is the also carbon atom. So the condition is, actually, this one is the ZnS structure, right? ZnS, half of the tetradal voids are occupied by zinc and the remaining are the sulfur ions. But instead of writing zinc, we have to write carbon. Instead of writing sulfide, again, we have to write carbon, and it gives a diamond structure. Okay, let's see the next part. In the diamond, carbon atom is a sphere. That means 8 corners plus 6 faces. Occupied 8 corners into 1/8, each corner occupies 1/8 part. So 8 corners into 180, it gives 1. Each face occupies half bar. That means 6 into half, it gives 3 items. So total occupied items from the corners and faces should be equal to 4. Then remaining carbon atoms are on the border diagonal, alternate tetrahedral. Border diagonal, alternate tetrahedral, both are same. So position, alternate border diagonal. Number of carbon atoms from the border diagonal tetrahedral void are the 4. So 4 carbon atoms from the border diagonal, 4 corner atoms are from the corner atoms and faces atoms. So that means the unit cell of diamond normally occupies 8 carbon atoms, but it is formed by 18 carbon atoms. Formed by 18 carbon atoms, 18, 8 from corners, 6 from faces, 4 from the border diagonal. So total becomes 18. But actually occupied, it should be equal to 8. So this is a simple structure of diamond, which is equivalent to ZNS. Now, the next part, spinal structure. Spinal structure AB2O4 is a spinal structure. Actually, AB2O4 is the formula for spinal as well as antispinal. A small difference is there. In the spinal structure, AB2O4, the charges of A, B, and O are A normally follows +2 charge, B follows +3 charge, oxygen follows -2 charge. So that means overall charge becomes neutral. We are having 1A with a +2 charge, 2B with a +3 charge. 2B with +3 charge means total becomes +6, and A +2. Again, total becomes +8 charge. So we are having +8 charge. To neutralize +8 charge, we are having 4 oxygen atoms. Each oxygen carries -2 charge. So 4 oxygen carries 8 minus 8 charge. So total becomes again neutral. So always each and every structure should be neutral in state. Then only it will exist naturally. Okay. Let's see the AB2O4 structure. AB2O4 structure follows FCC. In this one, we are having 3 particles. One is A, second one is B, and third one is the oxygen. So here, A and B are in positive state. So they are the voids. And oxygen is anion, so it should follow sphere position. Hence, the first part, oxygen follows sphere position. A +2 part, it should be tetrahedral void. We are having 8 tetrahedral voids. Suppose oxygen is a sphere. What is the position of sphere? 8 corners and 6 faces. Total number of occupied spheres, it should be equal to 4. Here we are having 4 spheres. When a unit cell contains 4 spheres at a time, there should be 4 octahedral void and 8 tetrahedral void, right? So, but here we are having only 1A. So out of 8 tetrahedral void, we have to use 1 tetrahedral void only. Hence, out of 8, we have to use 1 tetrahedral void. So that's why that indicates A +2 occupies 1/8 of the tetrahedral void. Why 1/8? 1/8 into 8, it becomes 1. That means we are having 1A. So E occupies 1/8 of the tetrahedral void. Understood? Then the B part. B +2 +3 ion occupies octahedral void, which is a bulkier than A +. B is normally bulkier than A +. So D occupies octahedral void. Again, if we are having 4 spheres, then there should be 4 octahedral voids. But actual number of B is 2. So out of 4, we have to use 2 octahedral voids only. That means half. So half of the octahedral voids are occupied by B plus. So this is the simple structure of AB2O4 spinal structures. In the spinal structure, oxygen occupies PS, A plus to occupy stateral void. So to balance the atoms out of a tetral void, we have to use one tetral only. Hence, 1/8 of the tetral voids are occupied by A plus 2 atoms. And half of the occupied voids are occupied by B atom. Then, examples of spinal structures. ZnAl2O4, MgAl2O4, ZnF2O4 are the simple examples. Now let's see the structure of spinal structure. Exact structure, exact position of oxygen A plus 2, B plus 3. Let's see. Oxygen ion is a sphere which is at 8 corners and 6 faces. That means it occupies 1/8 part of each corner into 8. That means 1 half part of each face into 6. That means 3. So total number of oxide ions, that means O2 minus ions, is equal to 4. So we are having 4 spheres in the FCC unit cells. Then A plus 2 ions, tetral void. Position, 1/8 of the tetral void. We are having 8 tetral voids. Out of 8, any of the tetral void is occupied by A plus 2 ion. So occupied, that is equals to 8 into 1/8. Out of 8, we have to occupy 1/8 only. That means 1 A plus 2 ion. That gives only 1 A plus 2 ion. Then B plus 3 ion. B plus 3 ion occupies the octetal void. So out of 4 octetal voids, we have to use only 2 octetal voids. So half of the octetal voids. So actually here it should be octetal voids. Half of the octetal voids are occupied by B plus 3 ion, right? So here it should be octetal void, not tetradal. Then occupied 4 into half. Out of 4, we have to use 2 only. That means half of the octetal voids. So that's why here we are having 2 B plus 3 ions. So a spinal unit cell contains 4 oxide spheres, 1 tetradal void, A plus 2, and 2 octetal voids, B plus 3. This is the spinal structure. Now let's see the antispinal structure. Antispinal structure is also known as inverse spinal structure. Antispinal structure is also known as inverse spinal structure. Spinal and antispinal both are having same formula, but there is a small difference in B. Again, here A plus 2 again having plus, A having plus 2 charge, B having plus 3 charge, oxygen having minus 2 charge. So overall charge becomes neutral. So that means charges are well balanced. AB2O4, spinal and spinal both follow the FCC structure. So that means again we are having oxygen. Oxygen it should be sphere, and spheres it should be on corners and faces. A plus 2. So A plus 2, A is a tetral void, smaller in size. We are having only one tetral void, A. Out of 8, because we are having 4 spheres, when we are having 4 spheres, there should be 8 tetral voids, but actually available one is the 1. So out of 8, we have to occupy 1 tetral void. That's why A plus 2 occupies 1/8 of the tetral void. B plus 3. This one is the change in the spinal and antispinal. So you have to remember this part only. The difference is the B plus 3, we are having 2 B plus 3 ions. So out of 2 B plus 3 ions, 1 B plus 3 ion occupies tetradal void, 1 B plus 3 ion occupies octetal void. So B is divided into 2 parts, octetal as well as tetradal. If you are having 4 spheres, at that time there should be 4 octetal voids. Right? So out of 2B, 1B is the octadal, 1B is the tetradal. So that means out of 4 octadal voids, we have to use 1 octadal void only. Out of 4, we have to use 1 octadal void. That means actually occupied B is 1/4 of the octadal void. Right? And out of 2B, 1B, if 1B occupies octadal, the second B, it should be a tetradal void. That means out of 8 tetradal voids, we are having only 1B tetradal void. So again, it should be represented by 1/8 of the tetradal void is occupied by B plus 1. Right? So let's see the counting. Counting of A, B, and O. Inverse spinal structure. Oxygen, again, it should be sphere. Position of sphere, 8 corners and 6 faces. Occupied, 8 corners into 1/8 part, 6 atoms into half part. So it gives total 4 oxide ions. Then A plus 1. The difference in spinal and anti-spinal structure is the B plus 3 only. So O2 minus and A plus 2, it should be on same position and should same number also. Here, A plus 2 ion is a tetradal void, which occupies 1/8 of the tetradal void. So occupied, it should be equals to 8 into 1/8, that is equals to 1A plus 2. We are having 1A plus 2 only, no? In second one, B plus 2 ion occupies octadal and tetradal void. So out of 2, 1B occupies 1 tetradal void and second B occupies 1 octadal void. So out of 4, we have to occupy 1 only, 1 octadal void only. So it should be represented by 1/4 of the octadal void. Out of 8, we have to occupy only 1 tetradal void. So it should be represented by the 1/8 tetradal void. So this is the position of B plus 3. Now, counting. Out of 8 tetradal void, we have to occupy 1/8 of the tetradal voids. That means 1 tetradal void. And out of 4 existing octadal voids, we have to occupy only 1 octadal void. That means 1/4 into 1/4, it gives 1. So 1 tetradal void of B plus 3, 1 octadal void of B plus 3, it gives 2 B plus 3 ions. That means inverse spinal structure. Again, spinal and anti-spinal structure both contains 1 A plus 2 ion, 2 B plus 3 ion, and 4 O2 minus ion. But the position of B plus 3 ion is changed in the inverse spinal. So that is a simple difference. Now, the next part is the corundum structure. This one is the last structure. Corundum. Corundum normally shows A2O3 type structure. Okay. In the A2O3, again A2O3 follows FC's HACP structure. HACP, hexagonal closed pack structure. So this one, A having plus 2 charge, O having minus 2 charge. So plus 3 into 2 for A, total plus 6 charge. Oxygen minus 2, each oxygen carries minus 2 charge. Here we are having 3 oxygens. So total charge becomes minus 6. So overall, it should be neutral in state. So A2O3 is always a neutral structure. Then in A2O3 follows HCCP structure. In A2O3, oxygen is the sphere. That means lattice points of HCP. We'll see the position of HCP, lattice points of HCP spheres. And A occupies voids, 1/8 of the tetradal voids. Why 1/8? It will be countable in the next part. So, a normal HCP in itself contains 6 spheres. How 6 spheres? 6 plus 6 corner atoms. Upper face, 6 corners of a hexagon. Lower face, 6 corners of a hexagon. So, total we are having 12 corner atoms. Each corner occupies 1/6 part. So, 12 into 1/6 should be equal to 2. We are having 2 face atoms. Each face occupies half of the part. So 2 into half equals to 1. So total becomes 3. And 3 spheres are at the center of the HCP in itself. So that's right. Total 12 corners into 1/4, 1/6, two faces into half, and three body center atoms. Total becomes 6 spheres. So if a unit cell contains 6 spheres, then there should be 6 octahedral voids and 12 double tetrahedral voids. HSCP is a closed packing structure, and only closed packing structure contains octahedral and tetrahedral voids. Now let's see the position and occupied atoms of A and O in coronal structure. Here, O2 minus ion is a sphere, which is at the 12 corners. How 12 corners? So 12 corners, out of 12 corners, corner atoms, 6 from one hexagon face and remaining 6 from opposite 6 hexagon face. So that becomes total 12 corner atoms, two faces, opposite faces of hexagon, two face hexagon atoms and three body centered atoms. So occupied should be equals to 12 into 1/6. Each corner atom in HSCP occupies 1/6 part. So 12 into 1/6 part plus 2 into half part plus 3 into 1. Each body center occupies complete atom. Na? So that's a plus 3. So total becomes 6 oxide ions. Then A+3N. A+3N normally occupies octahedral voids. Here we are having 6 spheres in the HCP in itself. So at that time there should be 6 octahedral voids. So position, 2/3 of the octahedral voids are occupied. Why 2/3? Let's see. Out of 6, if you are occupying 2/3 of the octahedral voids at that time, there should be 4 A+3 ions. Now, here we are having 6 oxides and 4 A. The formula becomes A4O6. That is a molecular formula, but simplest formula, A4O6 divide by 2, you will get A2O3 formula. So this one. So that means out of 6, we have to use 2/3 of the octahedral voids. Then it becomes 4 octahedral voids out of 6. So that means we're having 6 spheres and 4 octahedral voids, and it gives A4O6 formula. And the simplest formula should be A2O3. So this is the structure of corundum. Corundum follows HSCP structure. Remaining all structure follows FCC structure, and the cesium chloride also follows BCC structure. You have to remember all these points.